नमस्ते, गुड मॉर्निंग। आई जीवन ज्योति कुमार, फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड मेथोडोलॉजी। बिकॉज टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द टॉपिक नॉलेज एंड स्किल्स। एज आई हैव अर्ली डिस्कस अबाउट द बेसिक अबाउट दिस दीज टर्म्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द बेसिक डिफरेंस बिटवीन देम। दिस इज फ्रॉम द सब्जेक्ट नॉलेज एंड करिकुलम फॉर बीएड प्रोग्राम। Knowledge and information acquired through sensory input like reading, watching, listening, and touching, etc. And the concept of knowledge refers to a familiarity with factual information and theoretical concept. Knowledge can be transformed from one person to another, or it can be self acquired through observation and study. Skill, however, refer to the ability to apply knowledge to specific situation. Skills are developed through practice, through a combination of sensory input and output. And as an example, social skills are developed through interaction with people by observing, listening, and speaking with them. Trial and error is probably the best way to achieve skills mastery. To make it simple, knowledge is the theoretical and skills are practical. You can know all the rules of sport, know all the teams and all players, know all the statistics, but this only makes you knowledgeable about this sport. It does not make you any good at all. To become a good at the sport, you must play it, practice its technique, and improve your skills through experience. You don't need to know all the teams or all the players to practice a sport, and you can easily learn the rules as you play through trial and error. The same applies to a job. One can know a lot about a subject matter but might not have the skills required to apply that knowledge to a specific task, since knowledge does not provide skills. However, developing skills normally provides some knowledge as practicing those skills result is in sensory input. An example, an aerospace engineer may know a lot about avionics and flight theory, but this alone does not make him an aircraft pilot. On the other hand, an aircraft pilot only requires a minimum level of knowledge about organs and flight theory in order to be able to fly the plane, and the able will continue to increase as he gains experience flying a simulator or an actual plane. Now we have some topics about the developing skills in that. Therefore, if you want to be better prepare individuals to meet desired performance, they don't need more lectures. What they need is more practice, the production of the more presentation and more pages turns will only make people more knowledgeable. It will not provide them with skills to better to their job. Seems logical, no? Why then are so many learning professionals still addressing performance gaps with lectures, online presentations, or other theoretical content? In order for people to achieve a desired performance at a task, they must be provided with opportunity to perform the actions required so they can improve their performance at this task until they master it. While a lot of what is actually called training is basically nothing more than information dump, no surprise that such training program failed to deliver result. Training should be about activities, scenarios, and information, but when training is about lectures, presentations, and quizzes, we end up with individuals who know a lot of things but can't do much with it. Of course, skill can be developed more easily if one has prior knowledge of the task to be accomplished. Learning to fly a plane through trial and error without having a slight idea about how planes fly may be quite risky, but theory should be limited to the minimum required to be able to perform the task. You cannot learn how to drive a car without knowing where the accelerator and brake pedals are. However, the best way to learn the effect of acceleration and brakes is not to read about it, but to actually experience it. But, so, thank you. practice is the only way to develop your skills. The more you do something, the better you get at doing it. Thank you.